Hello everybody and welcome. I'm Son of Mowgef. It's Wednesday and I'm playing Thrive again. I've got a sweeper to thrive. Yep, that's a phrase that I used. I'm going to jump right in and see if I can get this guy sorted. I have been playing around with the bonding mechanic. It's still pretty damn wonky, but I'm going to play around with it a lot more. I might as well see if I can bond to this guy since he's here. Could you... here we go. No, don't kill yourself! Idiot. Dumb. The AI is so much worse than it used to be. I know I have devs in the comments and I'm sorry for that, but it is in fact true. I still have fun with it, though. Hey, could you maybe get the hell over here, please? Thank you. God, it's doing the thing already. Hang on. Close enough, I guess? I can use this guy to enhance my sweeper and my area of effect. That's the whole point of this type of organism, is to increase the area that you can use to absorb resources. I don't know why it keeps doing that in particular. I'm going to assume it's something to do with the shape of the organism that I've made. It's a bit of a weird shape. I am going to do more stuff with the bonding in particular and see if I can make a organism that bonds to others really, really well. But I'm pretty sure there's issues with the mechanic itself, so I don't know how effective changing the shape of something will be. It seems really quiet. Hang on a minute. I've turned it up a little bit. Well, there's a big cloud of resources over here. If I can sweep these up without getting the me that I'm attached to murdered, that would be cool. He says, going closer and closer to the poison. Wait, where are all the resources gone? There's some down here. There we go. Let's get this sweeped. Look, sweeping. I need to not get that thing killed. There we go. I've got enough for an evolution at least. Let me see if I can absorb that. Oh, I can't absorb anymore, can I? Because I changed to a solid shelled organism. I kind of forgot about that. I guess I'll let this guy go. I'll let him go over there so he doesn't immediately kill himself. Let's do an evolution here. Let's remind myself of where we are and what we're doing. Oh boy. Oh boy, look at this damn thing. Holy freaking hell. Have a look. There's no hydrogen sulfide here. There's plenty of light. And carbon dioxide, some nitrogen. I don't know if I really need anything else, to be perfectly honest. I could get some more ATP production or some more glucose. I could get something that produces more glucose, but I feel like I've got a lot of that stuff already. I've got like a whole bunch of mitochondrion, but I guess a little bit more wouldn't be awful. Like I could put that there and one over there, I think, maybe, yeah. Sure, I'm just gonna do it like that. Shore up this middle part and hope that it doesn't screw things up too much. So There's now three of me for some reason. Hey. Okay. Awesome. That's, again, a little bit weird. Why do you do this? Oh, I bonded to completely the wrong... Like, absolutely the wrong one. Look at how this has turned out. Look, it's so weird. I kind of like it. Oh, God. Oh, poo. It's, definitely strange. Let's unbond. Rebond. Come on. And I want to go over to you and have you bond on the other side of me, so I'm super wide. There we go. Oh god. Oh. Poo. There's a tiny little bit of iron there. I think that's what's doing it. Oh. Really? Oh, I picked that guy back up somehow. It got stuck. I'm just gonna leave that other guy just chilling out over there. That's not gonna do very well for me, is it? That's gonna cause a problem. See if I can get a decent bond with these guys. It's sadly quite awkward and doesn't work entirely well. Let's come on. I want you bonded to me and not the other one. No, it's gonna kill itself. No, don't do it. Stay away. There we go. I managed to convince it to live. Oh. Immediately it started doing this, whatever this is. It did it. There we go. And again. Like, it's a little bit frustrating that this doesn't work better. I feel like maybe the update that included bonding should have been delayed in its release, because it just, in its current state, it just doesn't work. And I've already mentioned, like, I'm pretty sure most of the issues that I'm having are with the shape of my organism as opposed to the actual mechanics, but I also feel like the mechanics don't work very well either. It's a little bit crazy. And I did change the attributes of the organism previously in an attempt to get to function a little bit better, and it was somewhat successful, but not entirely successful at the same time. There's a bunch of phosphate here that I don't really need. I mean, I can get a supply of it, I guess. Like a store of it. There's a little bit of iron up there. Let me maybe swim my way over here and see if I can find some resources. There was something in the patch notes talking about making resources like rarer the further you go along, but I was under the impression that was just glucose. It seems to have affected all the resources, because I don't know, they just feel rarer to me compared to previous times I've played. Oh, hang on, there's a whole bunch of stuff down here all of a sudden. When you're bonded to things. Oh, excuse me, that's my phone going off. My phone's actually on silent right now, by the way. My phone is in such a weird state currently. Like, the timer is just the strangest thing you'll ever use. I think I've mentioned it before. Hang on. There we go. Yeah, I've mentioned it before that if I set the timer, it just won't go off when I set it. But then when I manually check it, it'll say that the timer expired like tens of thousands of seconds ago. It'll be like 97,500 seconds ago that it expired. I'm like, I feel like that's inaccurate. I feel that's like months worth of seconds. I sure as hell didn't set that. months ago. Look, it's a couple of minutes at best. So I can't use the timer on my phone. And it doesn't go on silent when you set it on silent. It's really, really strange. I think it's just the software on it's corrupt. I might just check it just to see what that update was. Oh, it wasn't an update. It was a text from Devil Princess. Hey, Devil Princess. I'm not actually going to check the message immediately, but might as well see if it was, you know, immediately important. Sometimes it'll go off and there'll be like no update to read. It'll just play the notification noise. And sometimes it doesn't do it at all. Until I use the phone. Like if I pick up the phone and unlock it to use it, it will then give me like 10 notifications in a row. So weird. I really should just get a new phone, but I only really use it for text messaging and phone calls, and it works for that, so might as well continue until it's completely dead. Anyway, back to Thrive. I think what I'm going to do here is have a swim around for a bit and see if I can find these resources that I need. I'm really not having that much luck right now. Yay, so I'm back. I've actually been swimming around like 10 minutes and I have found some ammonia. You can see from here, look, that it's not all the way filled there, but it is there. And I've also just got my buddy stuck. So I'm going to unbond and see if that fixes things. Apparently now that I have no ammonia as backup, which is bizarre, but like I said, there is some here, so I should be able to collect it. Oh, that really was a very small amount. There's a little bit apparently right there. I'm not sure how this whole, you know, resource sharing thing works. Yeah, there's a cloud of it here. The other me that I released is gonna... Oh, I was gonna say it's gonna kill itself, but it didn't. It just got stuck. But I was gonna have to release it anyway in order to do the evolution. Assuming that I can, you know, stay alive long enough to actually make use of it. I like the way that other me is so utterly stuck there right now. I understand that there was a change in the AI when the bonding update thing came out. And it needs work. It's I don't know. I'm sure I mentioned this previously, but the way the new AI for the other organisms works is that it just ignores anything in its path. It just swims around randomly, and if it bumps into something, like these chunks of iron that you can see floating around here, it'll just get stuck. And if it's something that causes damage, like another organism or these little clouds of poison, then it just kills itself. It just dies immediately. It's kind of funny. Oh, I've got enough resources here for an evolution. I was so busy yakking and complaining and saying things that I hadn't noticed. I think I'm going to just go ahead and use that. There are some resources around here, so it'll do me good. Although, I'm going to have to admit, I'm not entirely sure what I'm going to do here. I am using up some glucose here. Not like I could just balance that out with maybe a thylakoid or two. Where can I pop this? Can I pop this? I'm trying desperately not to overdo it. All right, so that made it better. Much better, but not quite fixed. But I'm all right with this for now. Oh, never mind. I may have thrived. I wasn't expecting that, actually. I was just doing me thing, so... That's a sweeper that we got thrived. It went much better this time than it did last time. Those of you that didn't watch my previous attempt at a sweeper, there was an issue with the physics where it was too wide and too thin. It would cause issues with the physics engine, I believe, and it would cause like random flipping and warping, which would crash the game. This one actually hasn't crashed the game yet, which is kinda nice. Really very nice. I think next week I'm definitely going to start on a new organism that's specifically designed to be easy with the bonding thing mechanics. I've just noticed there's a whole bunch of stuff up there. Let me just play quickly with the... Oh, no, that's the wrong menu, because there's a micro builder. Just so I can get it straight in my head before I start next week, the kind of thing that I'm going with. Let me think. I'm gonna need a nucleus. I don't know, like, I'm not sure how big I would want it. Maybe something like this? And then I can bring it out. I'm gonna need some thylakoids. I'm not building a legitimate organism here. I'm just, like, I don't know. I'm just messing around with it, see if I can make something that might actually work. I'm gonna use these cytoplasms as like rudimentary building blocks. And then I guess I could build across here, like that. I had some of these before, so I'll add those in. So maybe something like that? So it's got nice long wide edges for it to bond with on the other ones. I don't know if that makes any difference or not. Let's have a look. So, oh, that's going to be... Oh, no, that's actually... I accidentally did that. Look, that's a brilliant place to have that. I did that completely on purpose and not entirely by accident. And then I'd have a couple of these, I believe. And some actual bonding... can you only ever have one? Oh, I can't make it symmetrical now. People are going to not like me for that. This thing does not do well for glucose, but then... Hang on. This is where I was before... Oh, wait. Oh, do I have to move patch by patch? That's a little awkward. There we go. Right, let's go ahead and do that. So I'm in a good place for the thylakoids and the chloroplasts and whatnot. Maybe I can add... Oh god, I'm actually going to need more of these, aren't I? Can I maybe jam one in here? Alright. Something like... oh no. Not like that. That? I feel like that's different to this. This is not how I would want it, but let's just chuck that into a world and see. Oh, I forgot to change the rigidity of it, but hey, you, come over here. Come and do some bonding. It's a bonding exercise. I've got no flagella either, so that was a bit of a dumb move. But I kind of want it to be a bit uniform. Oh, really? Bond? Come on. Do the bonding thing. Yes. Okay, so that's pretty cool. Let me just see if I can find another me briefly. I should be ending the video, but... Okay, sadly, I'm going to have to leave it there. I've been swimming around for quite a long time, like 20 minutes or so, and I found one other... one other me, and it killed itself before I could bond to it. So, yeah, it might be just because the population is very low. I used the editor rather than playing through, so the populations are a little bit on the low side. But you can see there's a bunch of other not-mes swimming about. And they seem to do so somewhat randomly. Like, I've been talking about this on and off quite a lot in this video. But if I wanted to find another member of my species, or any other species for that matter, I could just find like a little cloud of resources and they'd kind of show up, since they used to seek out resources. I feel like they don't do that anymore. They, yeah, they move around somewhat randomly and they don't avoid these poison clouds, so they die quickly and easily. And they get stuck on other things equally easily. So, that is a bit of an issue, especially with the low population. So what I'll do is I'll call it quits there for this week's episode of Thrive. And then I'll start a brand new organism next week that will be something roughly like this. I mean, this guy has been attached to me the whole time. It hasn't popped off. It hasn't got stuck. It doesn't do that, like, random thing where it rotates in the opposite direction as you, or me. By you, I mean me. And by me, I mean this organism. But work that chain of thought out, but yeah, I feel like it's a little bit... The circumstances are bad currently, I feel like. So hopefully between now and next week there'll be like some fixing going on that will help reduce this kind of problem. Like, there are still quite a lot of issues with this bonding update. Although I've been having a hell of a lot of fun with it, and I'm very, very much looking forward to seeing where this goes. I kind of feel like maybe this update should have been delayed until it was more functional than it currently is, but, you know, the devs for this game have done a freaking stellar job so far, and they've created something really kind of special, so... although, you know, things aren't particularly brilliant with the condition of the game now, I am still going to keep playing it, and I'm still going to have a blast, and I'm sure I'm still going to make an absolute dumb mess of things, so, yeah, keep at it, devs. What was I going to say? Yeah, that's this week's episode of Thrive. I'm just going to do this. Yeah, that's this week's episode of Thrive. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Comments in the comments section, especially if you've got, like, hints and tips and things for... ways to make the bonding more effective, or, you know, shape ideas that would work quite well. I'm interested in hearing all of that, because I will eventually be trying to break the record for the most cells bonded together. I think it's 33. I'm sure I remember reading that it was 33 cells in a single colony. I do want to try and beat it. So that's going to be awesome. But I also want to wait until, you know, things work a little bit better. So like and subscribe if you haven't already done that. And come back tomorrow. I'll be doing more ecosystem, which is, yeah, also a lot of fun. Recently discovered a lot of the problems I've been having with the ecosystem are entirely my fault. Surprise, shock and horror with that one. So I'm going to be taking things a little bit slower. Building up things in a slightly different way. Yeah, and you guys should come along and join in for that. That would be awesome. So, yeah, I'm Son of Mowgef. This is Thrive. I'll see you soon.